Oh, welcome back everybody. So today we're going to get on with some force armor and a bit of exploration. Now I think I've created everything I need. So take our force armor. Now some of these recipes were quite expensive, they needed diamonds. So we'll go through what I'm going to install on the suit. First of all, so on all the pieces I'm wanting the energy shields, and then we're wanting the elite battery in each as well. Right, so while we're looking at the boots, I would like the shock absorbers installed. That's going to save us from fall damage. And we'll play around with the values eventually. Okay, so I'm going to install a solar generator that's going to allow us to power up the suit or keep power in the suit. I want a jetpack, I want to be able to fly. And here we're going to have a kinetic generator, so when we're moving we will generate the power back. Now we're going to have all of these, so sprint assist, jump assist, swim boost, and uphill step assist. That means we can walk up one block no problem. Actually I need to start wearing this. So you can see the power on the right hand side there. Now we're not getting much, so we do need to tinker with things. I'm going to install night vision mainly to be able to see underwater. We've applied the swim assist. Let's see, what else did we want? We're going to want a cooling system. That's going to save us in the nether. And we're going to install a water tank. Now, do I not have everything I need? So the water, if you get set on fire, it can put you back out. So we need two control circuits, I think. Oh no, we've got two control circuits. We have a bucket. What else was it looking for? Eight glass. Okay. Oh no, we've got that as well. Why is it? Why are we not able to install that? Water bucket. Right, we're still moving pretty slowly, so I want to get that tweaked up as well. Okay, so let's tweak this up. Tank size 200 buckets, that's fine. So if we go and sit in here, you can see that there's a new thing turned up on the right hand side. It's going up at the moment. That's the amount of water buckets you have on you to put yourself out when you're on fire. Just another way to keep cool. You can see on the right hand side by the power, which is shown as 3,000,000, 2.9, so it's using power as I'm moving around, but then replenishing itself by the kinetic generator, maybe by the solar power. You see there's that orange bar, that's the how cool the suit is, and we want to tweak the cooling so that we do remain cool, but that's at the cost of energy, but as we're moving around it's replenishing itself, so that's fine. Next up we want to tweak the movement speed. So we don't need, let's do walking assist and set that to 150, see how that feels. Okay, that's fast enough for me. I don't need to go too fast. And let's see what sprint's like. Okay, so that's the same. So let's tweak sprint up. So that's at 200. If we're having to sprint, we might as well make it fast. Okay, so walk speed's about the same speed as the normal sprint, then that's double the speed. Okay, what else can we tweak? I'm not going to bother with any of these. So for our jetpack, we want to be able to thrust. Let's stick that up to 100 and see how that feels. And how much energy we're using up as well. Okay, I think I'm going to bump that all the way up. You can see that we're still getting some heat. But it's cooling, we're cooling down as well. It's because we're in the desert. So let's put the jetpack or thrust all the way up. Cooling, right, that's as much cooling as we can have. And the tank size is fine. Swim boost. I'm going to put that all the way up. Uphill step assist is fine. Jump, maybe won't be doing much with that. And we want to make sure that we mitigate all damage when we land, because we're going to be going quite high up with this suit. So let's see how we're going with the heat on the right hand side, the power consumption when we're just powering through. Now, the heat thing seems to be new in this version, and you know, despite the fact that we've got the cooling set to maximum, you do occasionally need to land, so I'm not going to use the flight assist. Okay, well anyway, that's pretty cool. So we've now got the suit on, and that's going to allow me to feel more comfortable when we go exploring in our other world. Let's get rid of my old suit. Feels much better to be walking around. Now, why did I have an LV capacitor? There was something else I was wanting to install, was there? Our water electrolyzer, yeah. Okay, so that'll stop us from drowning. Let's go and check out our other world. Need to get used to it again. It does help you move around a lot faster, and also will take less damage when you're moving. It's still rainy in this world, and this may well be done. Oh no, I'm still going. Let's see how deep it is. As you can see, I'm not drowning. You can see a bit clearer than you would normally when you're underwater, and that's because we do have the night vision on. Now I know it's been picking up diamonds because I was using the diamonds for it looks like we've came down through. Well, that's interesting little shapes on the bottom here. Well, yeah, we were having to use the diamonds for the suit. Okay, well you can see I'm moving pretty fast through the water as well, and I'm not drowning, so that all seems to be working fine. It's about 2 rows from finishing there. Okay, so if we go north from here, there's a few things. There was this thing here that we're going to check out now, now that we've got a decent suit to go and have a look inside. This would be normally fully dark, but it's because we've got the night vision on. I'm not sure why nothing spawned. Oh well. Oh, something has spawned. Okay, let's check these chests. Nothing of too much interest in there. I'm going to take the chest with me as well. Now, normally you'd have a little fight when you get in here, but I think it's the speed of me travelling across to this improve things. Okay, that looks a bit more interesting. Yeah, so by me flying across to it. I've not really lit up this place very well. Oh, I'm taking quite a bit of damage, so we need to go and fix that. So we wouldn't have been saved. Or safe, in any way. Okay, so let's get the armour. You can see the armour down the bottom there, and I didn't... because I didn't have any of the field strength set on any of these items. It was like I was wearing no armour at all, which isn't too healthy when you're wandering around in an expensive kit. Might have been tricky to get back. Anyway, that's me now at full armour. Okay, well, now that we've got this Now that we've got this force armour sorted out, let's go and have a look and investigate this. Oh, there's mobs spawned already. Hopefully we don't die or take too much damage. So we're not taking that much damage now. Let's see, is anything good in here? Is that a ghast tier? Yeah, cool. Well, some good stuff, but not brilliant. Anyway, these little hills are great for collecting some of this mossy cobblestone if you're looking for it. So I've remembered something that was worth exploring over this way. There's some chests that I found in the past that there was three of them together, but I was getting pretty beaten up when I was trying to collect them. So, because I didn't have decent armour on. Now we do. Hoping for a portal gun. I might have made it to that one already. No, there was another one. There we go. Yeah, there's three of them really close together. Remember that? Ah, well, no portal gun. And there's nothing spawning anymore. That's a bit odd. Like, you get the wisps normally around them, but they're not spawning. So do we get anything good? If you get silk touch on these books, that'd be pretty handy. Oh, there we go. It is spawning. And they're difficult to attack when you're not using arrows. So I need to sort myself out with some arrow production. Okay, I can take a hint, I'm off. I'm going to skirt around my area now that I can fly and see if I can find anything else of interest. So I shall see you in a little bit. I did find this place before. It's pretty interesting looking bit of landmass. Anyway, we're off scouting, so I shall see you in a bit. Well, this is interesting. I found the pickaxe of the core in another one of these, not too far away from the last one. Let's grab this and get out of here. Thromcraft tree here. Ah, well, nothing that exciting. The trees with the cobwebs, and if you don't know the Thorncraft trees, they will they always have a chest underneath a cave spider spawner. Welcome back, guys. So next up, wanted to get this other farm up and running. Ah, oh, great. So these guys will trample over all your crops. I thought I'd lit up this area pretty well. And maybe these guys will spawn in the light anyway. this should all be fine over here. Anyway, you've seen now what I've got going on here, and I think I'm gonna have to find out where those guys are spawning. But anyway, thought I'd like to get some wheat going. We're gonna be setting up a manual farm here. Oops. And that means the crops will be replanted, but not the initial crops. So that's why I've got everything planted. I've got rubber trees there for the sap, for the resin. Got cactuses, reeds, and wheat. Let's get out of here. Okay, so I need a few things. First thing I'm going to need is a soldering iron. That's bronze and iron. I've also already created some of these electron tubes. You saw me create a tin electron tube. The recipe for all the electron tubes. So use a thermionic fabricator. Here's the gold one. Diamonds. Just some of the black rubber, not the MFR stuff, I believe it is, and bronze in that pattern with the redstone. Okay, that should be made. Okay, so we've got the soldering iron, and need one more thing made up here. I just place this up in this location because, so it's a circuit board here, gives us access to some water and power, which is all we need to get this running. And it's going to be, you know, ad hoc stuff I'm making with this thing. Well, a few comments about what we've got going on outside. As you can see, in line with the 3x3 area there, and to the north of that, we've got our trees, and then to the south of it we've got our cactus. So that's 3x3 corresponding to, sorry, yeah, it's 3 wide. That corresponds to those three. The reeds on that side, and then the wheat on that side. I think that's all set up right. I think that's the way the farm divides itself up anyway. Okay, so let's grab the soldering iron with this. Do I use it on that, or...? Okay, so right click on the soldering iron, then we place this here, switch this to manual farm. So the north side is rubber, have to check. So the order of the electron tubes, I'm just reading this from the wiki. The circuit board determines the orientation for each section of the farm. The orientation is as follows. North, south, west, and east. So north is a rubberized electron. And what was next? North, south. South is a cactus, which is a golden electron tube. Um, west is the reed farm, and east. So hopefully that's okay. Let's plug it in and see. Rubber, crops, succulent, whatever that means. And reed. Okay, so I think the only thing this needs now is fertilizer. So here's our import bus. Tell it to craft these. And it's already full and seems to be working. Right, let's get upstairs before that guy destroys our crops. I think what we need... Oh god, what a mess he's made. Ah, well, at least give us a heart. Right, okay, well, it appears to be working. The cactus was being harvested. Reeds are being harvested. Resin looks like it's already gone. And the wheat has been harvested, and you can see the seeds have been replanted as well. So I've got a bit of fixing up to do here, but yeah, that all seems to be working fine. It's only harvesting the top level of the cactus and the reed farm, so that's fine. Okay guys, so now that I've got some rubber or resin coming into the system, I think it's time to get on with some IC2 stuff. I've just smelted up some iron, or made some refined iron from iron. I want to get that encoded into the system because that's going to become... Well, we're going to need quite a lot of refined iron. I think eventually I'm going to replace the furnaces with that I'm using here for smelting ores and other jobs with IC2 machines, because we can get them to go faster. But for the time being, we're going to use these machines, and I'm just going to tell it to get us some refined iron prepared. Okay, so we're going to want an extractor to extract our resin. And we're going to need some resin cooked up. So I'm going to teach the system about copper cables, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, so welcome back. So I've programmed in some IC2 stuff. I sort of find machine blocks and copper cables. I also told the system how to make force ingots, because I've got a lot of force nuggets. Now I can use two force ingots to create two electronic circuits for the same number of copper, so that seemed quite efficient, so that's why I've done that. Glass fiber cables, using the silver to get six rather than the four I think you get as standard. Got the extractor programmed in, batteries, furnace, iron furnace, generator, and a bat box. And I'm not going to create the bat box immediately. I want to just create the generator. And I want to create the extractor. And I'm doing this before I create the bat box, so I'm not wasting too much resin without the extractor. Okay, I'm also going to want an export and import bus. Let's take that. And we'll do a precision. Do I need that? Yeah, okay. It might be running pretty fast, so we'll get it importing nice and fast as well. And we're going to take bit of resin down with us. And let's... I think this is the resin rubber, so we might as well tell it how to extract from that. I'm going to leave those for the time being. That's the rubber that comes from MFE. MFR, Mine Factory Reloaded. I might have mentioned that earlier on, but just use the acronym. Okay, so there's our import bus. Maybe we'll need a little bit more ME cable. Okay, so I've looped around my ME cable. It goes runs underground through to here. And what I'm planning to do is have my generator here for the time being, with space for the bat box underneath it, and then we can have the extractor just here. If you can hear some hammering, that's next door neighbours. And there's where the extra cable goes. Okay, so the precision import bus, we can move stacks, and the export bus will just program it in to take those and move stacks. So that's ready to go. Let's get some coal. And of course this is just temporary until we start to expand the system. Okay, so we're now extracting our resin. We'll get three rubbers per resin, so that's cool. I'm just going to convert it all into rubber. I'm not going to have that crafted on as needed. I don't see any reason to keep the resin kicking around. Okay, so now that we have some rubber going into the system, it's time for me to get a bat box. Remember, you can program in the recipes without needing the items. And we're going to place this underneath here, underneath the generator. So I'm probably going to need a wrench for this. Do I have... oh, I do. Must have been using that for something. Okay, let's go underneath. Right, I'm just going to remove this wire here. We don't want anything exploding, not that. I'm pretty certain it wouldn't. But okay, so I'm going to wrench just the bottom, no holding down shift. Oh no, shift wrench. Nope. Why is that not working? Which way is it? Is that pointing it upwards? So let's try shift wrench. No. So shift wrench is getting the output there. I'll see if I can figure this out. Okay, I figured it out. I had to shift wrench it from standing up here. Shift wrench always moves it in the opposite direction from where you're facing, so kind of got lucky on that one, I reckon. Not sure why, just normally just right, or maybe it was left click I should have been using rather than right click. No, right click normally points it in the direction that you're facing it on, but or that was what used to happen. Anyway, I'll shift left click it from here again. If I get myself positioned right, it should work. Okay, so there's the output. That's all we're really looking for. So now I can fill in this hole, and we're able to keep an eye on how much power we have in our battery box, and now we can just get the generator up and running. In fact, we don't want to waste the coal. But you can see we've got power coming into the battery box and our extractor's up and running. So I think that's probably a good time to to stop today. We've done quite a bit. We've started on IC2 stuff. We've got a farm up and running. We're wearing force armor, and we've had a little bit of exploration. So that's all very good. Next episode, I'm probably going to continue with IC2 and put in a more substantial system than what we have here. Okay, well, thank you all for watching, and I shall see you next time.